Have you ever wondered, some things float on water and some sink in water? Why does it happen? Let's find out. Hello viewers, I'm Leena Bhasker. Welcome to my channel. I regularly upload videos related to science and education. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, take a moment to subscribe it for such wonderful videos in future. For floating and sinking, is it the weight or the mass of an object that is really important? Probably not. Otherwise, such a heavy ship will sink in an ocean or a sea. So, is it the size of an object that really matters? Probably not. When you are bathing and the soap accidentally slips into your bucket, it sinks in water, whereas an empty mug will float on the surface of water, mug being bigger in size than the soap. So what makes an object to float or sink? One of the important factors is density, which is defined as mass per unit volume. But there are other factors also, like gravitational force, like buoyant force and the pressures on the fluid that comes into play and are very important and crucial in deciding whether an object will float or sink in water. So let's understand density in a more simpler manner. All objects are made up of particles. So if the particles are close to each other, the object is more denser. And if the particles are far away from each other, the object is said to be less denser. As I told you, density is mass per unit volume. The density of water being 1 gram per cubic centimeter. So anything which is less denser than this will float on the surface of water, and anything which is more denser than this will sink in water. So now it's time to find out what sinks and what floats on water.
I have got few things. I'm going to put them in water one by one. Let's see what floats and what sinks. So the first thing is this piece of foam. Let's see. It floats on water. Okay. The second thing is this orange pebble. Let's see. It sinks in water. The third thing I have taken is a plastic spoon. Okay, a broken plastic spoon. Let's see. It floats on water. Okay, let me try with a piece of wood. Let's see what happens. Oh, it floats. And then the next thing I have is a key with me. Okay, so let's see what happens. A key sinks in water. You can hear the sound also. Okay, key must be heavy, but I have this small nail. Let's see what happens. Okay, the nail is small, but the density is more. So it sinks. And then I have this plastic cap with me, a red plastic cap. Let's see. Okay, it is almost floating. And I have this band with me, the wrist band, the friendship band. Let's see. Okay, let it go down. Yes, it is sinking. And now I have this penny or this coin with me. Let's see. It sinks. Metals make a sound. But now I have a metal, small metal bowl, steel bowl. So let's see what happens. Oh, it floats, right? So you can also collect so many things at your home and do the experiment in interesting way, in whatever way you like. Pick up things around your home and do it yourself. Some more dramatic. I'm going to add some cubes of ice to water and let's see what happens. See, the ice is floating on the surface of water. Why? Ice is also water. Ice is a solid form of water. So when water solidifies into ice, what happens is the volume of the water increases. That is why ice floats on water, because its density is less than water. Remember, density is mass upon volume. So when the volume increases, the density becomes less. Similarly, this is a big packet of snacks, but it will float on water because it has air, it has nitrogen in it. So it will always float on water.